As you look across the state, there's no red flag warnings in place, no elevated fire weather concerns, at least right now. That's a different story. Last week, we had several red flag warnings in place. Of course, getting ready for a cool front that brought the showers on Monday. We're looking at bringing a cool front across the state. We'll talk about its impacts in just a few moments, but it's a mild start here along the Wasatch Front. We've got low 60s from Salt Lake City through Ogden, currently 58 degrees in Provo. Again, winds, nothing of great strength, anywhere between 5 to 10 miles per hour. Pollen situation, boy, I was suffering yesterday. The culprit, well, as we look towards the tree, specifically mulberry, it is high right now. And of course, we're getting a break from the rain. We're just going to look at pollen situation becoming even worse heading into the weekend. Now, for today, we're forecasting temperatures once again in the 80s, not quite as warm yesterday as we tied a record yesterday in Salt Lake City at 84. Today it's 82, but well off the average mark where we should be in the upper 60s. Now, these temperatures is what we typically experience, kind of the 10th to 11th day of June. So we're about a month ahead temperature-wise, at least for today. Bringing more clouds on the forecast, we're going to see less blue sky. That's all due to a cool front that gets here a little bit later on, moving into the afternoon. We're going to see a big temperature drop. But what about the chance of showers associated with this cool front? Well, we're seeing those clouds, yes. A few very light rain showers in southern Idaho. That might be an area we could see a sprinkle from Tremont and Snowville over towards the north end of Cache Valley. But Wasatch Front stays dry, as well as the rest of the state. There's the cool front. So it's the warm before that cool front hitting. But again, we're talking about the chances of showers. What do we see? Well, we know today we've got the clouds in place, northern central Utah. From our models, as you look, we don't see much activity as that cool front swings through a little bit later on. It's kind of mid-afternoon. Behind the front come tomorrow, our second wave does bring a chance of some scattered rain showers from northern central into northeastern Utah. We're talking a 20 to a 30% chance. Better possibility, though, from Price over towards Vernal for tomorrow. Then we get some wraparound moisture that hits Monday morning, at least across eastern Utah, southwest Wyoming. So this storm doesn't pack the punch as far as precipitation is concerned. It will kick up winds just a little bit throughout the afternoon. It gets a little breezy. Again, no wind advisories in place, but ahead of that front, temperatures will be climbing back into the 80s from Provo through Salt Lake City, 80s in Price. Again, some hot temperatures towards southern Utah, 90s in Moab. Looks like low 90s in St. George, where you've got some clouds today. Partly cloudy skies tomorrow. It looks to be cooler. We're into the 80s. Then it's sunny and clear thereafter as we go from 70s, which is quite nice Monday, and then back into summer temperatures and summer heat by Wednesday and Thursday. We're looking at low to mid 90s. Now for northern Utah, we see a decent temperature swing tomorrow. We're down into the 60s. Chance of scattered showers, especially throughout the afternoon. Again, it's not a great chance, but we could see some brief rain for tomorrow. Then we don't see rain thereafter as, once again, high pressure building back in. We go from 60s to 70s and 80s returning Thursday and Friday. Now, we like to see temperatures and warm temperatures. We do not like to see the lack of rain where we only get a slight chance come tomorrow and then it's dry thereafter.